acquisition process, which is the business plan and acquisition plan. Before, I will let you know what are the phases in the acquisition process. So, the first one, there is business plan. And then the second phase, there is acquisition plan. Third one, there is search. Fourth one, there is screening. Fifth, there is the first contact. And then there is negotiate. And so integration plan, closing. Then there is another integration. And then the last one is the evaluation. In this video, I will explain to you more about the first two phases, which is the business plan and acquisition plan. The business plan, there are several things that we have to talk about in the business plan. The first one is external analysis. The second one is internal analysis. Third one, there is mission statement. And then there is objectives. Then there is business strategy. Also, implementation strategy. Then there is functional strategy, and the last one is strategy control. I will try to explain you one by one of these things in business plan. The first one is external analysis. In external analysis here, we use Michael Porter's Five Forces framework. The first one is customers. Customers are the people, our target market, who gonna buy our product. And then the second one, there is current competitors. Current competitors are the people or the firms that probably gonna try to steal our target markets or our customers. The third one, there is potential entrants. These firms are usually the new firms that are gonna be our competitors in the future. Next, there is substitute products. The firms that are gonna replace us are gonna be the substitute of our products. Then there is suppliers, the people that support our business, so our business will keep going on and on and on. Next, there is external and internal analysis. For internal and external analysis, we use the SWOT, or SWOT analysis. S represents the strength, W represents the weaknesses, O represents opportunities, and T represents the threats. Strength and weaknesses is more like in our internal analysis, and opportunity and threats is more like external analysis. Next, we have mission statement. Mission statements defines direction and provides means of communicating sufficiently with key stakeholder groups. Here we will try to communicate what are our missions, what are the missions of our company to the stakeholders. Next, we do have business objectives. Business objectives is what must be accomplished within a period of time. It's more about specific period. So it's about timing, when are we gonna achieve something. Next, we do have business strategies. For business strategies, there are two things. The first one is corporate level strategy, which cover the growth strategy, diversification strategy, operational restructuring strategy, and financial restructuring strategy. The second strategy, we have business level strategy, which consists of price or cost leadership, product differentiation, focus or niche strategy, and hybrid strategies. Then we will talk about implementation strategy. In this implementation strategy, there are solo ventures, mergers or acquisition, alliances, which consists of joint ventures, partnerships, or licensing. And then the other one, there is minority investments, which cover less than 20% of the shares, and asset swaps. And then there's another one, functional strategies. Functional strategies focus on short-term results and generally are developed by functional areas. These strategies result in a series of concrete actions for each functions or businesses groups, depending on the company's organizations. So what consists in functional strategies? There are research and development, marketing and sales, human resources, finance, legal, tax department, and the other department that will support the business itself. The next one is strategy controls. In strategy controls, we use two systems. The first one is incentive systems, and then the second one is monitoring systems. The incentive system, we use bonus or profit sharing. Meanwhile, in monitoring systems, we use accounting-based financial measures or activity-based variables. Those are the business plan that we have already covered. The next one, we do have acquisition plan, or the second phase. In the acquisition plan, there are 9 terms that we have to talk about. The first one is plan objective. It's about how acquisition plan objectives can be linked with business plan objectives. So they must complement each other, they must link to each other, they must relate to each other. And then the second one is timetable. Basically, timetable is defined by activity completion dates or deliverables, or like what is to be achieved in what certain times, or individual responsible for satisfying objectives. It's more like when we have to do things, when we have to be done with things. For the third one is resource or capability review. In this resource or capability review, we determine maximum size of acquisition in terms of PE, or price per earnings, sales, cash flows, purchase price, and etc. And then we also have to assess internal management capabilities, like can acquire continue to manage current businesses as well as integrate the acquired firm or no. The next one, we do have management preference. For this management preference, we need senior management guidelines to give them advice of what to do, whether we have to use cash only to buy the target firm or prefer an asset or stock purchase. Or maybe will we consider competitors as the potential targets or not? Or maybe do we want the controlling interest or not? Or do we have to limit EPS dilution to 2 years following closing or not? And then the next one, we have search plan. In this search plan, there are 2-step procedures. The first one is by establishing primary selection criteria, for example, industry and maximum size of transaction. The second one is to develop search strategy to identify potential targets using computerized databases, directory services, legal, banking, and accounting firms, and the internet. The next one is negotiation strategy. In this negotiation strategy, we have to refine the valuation, and we also have to conduct due diligence and deal structuring to satisfy the highest priority needs of all parties involved. Next, we have to determine initial offer price. In this determining initial offer price, we as the buyer have to estimate the minimum purchase price that we have to pay to the target price, and also the synergy created by combining acquired and target firms. Also, we have to determine how much percentage of synergy we will share to the target firm. The next one, there is financing plan. In this financing plan, we have to determine whether the proposed transaction can be financed. Like, how are we gonna pay the target firm? Are we gonna buy them with stock, issuing stock, or are we gonna pay them in cash? The next one, there is integration plan. For integration plan, it's developing the integration plan, includes identifying the key actions and understanding the key resources required to implement the integration of the business. So in here, we will have the conclusion, which is the post-closing integration. In here, it will involve implementing effective communication plans, retaining key managers, identifying funding and immediate operating cash flows requirements, employing best practices of both firms, and addressing cultural issues. And that's all for me. Thank you.